Happy Lord's Day, everyone.
Do
you long for the good old days? We all long to go back to our old normal before this pandemic. But we may also be longing for a golden era even beyond that. Maybe we feel that all the years before have been better. Perhaps you feel that society has gotten worse. Morality was better then, music was better, food was better, maybe everything was better then. Those of us in ministry may feel like people today don't have commitment or do not care about the church that much. But no one is immune to nostalgia or looking at the past with rose-tinted glasses. That is when we remember the past as much better than it actually was. To give an example, I hear a lot of people, myself included, complain about the music today being very shallow and immoral. But take a long, hard look at the actual list of songs released in that era you fondly remember, and I bet there would be a lot of horrible and shallow songs as well. But since what survives over the years are the best ones, then we unconsciously think of the past eras as always better. We also say that the singers and bands today are very immoral and bad role models. But guess what? A lot of the classics were actually bad role models as well. Everyone reveres the Beatles because they were good. But they were horrible role models, showcasing a lifestyle of sex and casual drugs. But we remember them fondly because they're part of this golden era in our minds.
因为这个是在我们所活到的这个黄金的时代里面出名的一些音的歌星。
Were the past decades really better for society or our church?
是不是过去的时代是真正是比咱现在的时代啊，人讲是较好呢？
It may be that for a specific group of people, it really was.
现在对一个真正特殊的一群的人来讲，可能是真是比较较好的啊。
Maybe for you, for me, for our family, our community, our town, it was really better in the past.
现在对咱、对你、对咱、对你的家庭、对你的所徛起的这个城市。可能真是客观上是更加好诶。
No one can argue with that because that is our experience.
无人无会叫你用这个来争论，因为这个是一个个别的经验。
But if you take into account what was happening in the whole world, was there ever really the good old days?
但是你好好来靠观看，你全这个世界里面所发生的每件代志时阵。你敢有法能讲，真是过去的日子是较好吗
？Of course, it's going to be very hard to objectively measure if things have been, you know, going better or worse overall.
当然，咱真艰苦，以客观的方面来衡量，到底过去的日子是较好还是较歹啊
？Of course, with the pandemic, we can say that right now, today is worse than before 2020.
我通真确定的讲说啊，因为这个疫情的关系啊，今仔日啊，比疫情之前时阵啊，一定啦是搁较歹啊。
But my point is, things have never been really better.
我所要提醒的就是讲说啊，事实上啊，代志并不是。真就顶咱所思想的以前较好诶。
This is a world that has rebelled against God.
因为咱所徛起的这个世界啊，是反叛上帝的世界。
In a very real sense, this is a fallen world.
咱国家真正的来公告这个世界其实是一个堕落的世界。
You are never in a time of peace, even if your country is not at war.
虽然你国家并无咧比甲人相战啊，但是啊，咱事实上也是无活伫一个真正平静和平的时代。
Now, as believers, I really believe that we can experience the greatest joy possible, even while we're here on earth because of Jesus.
但是我却相信讲，咱做一个信徒啊。就是咱一个徛伫这个世界的时阵啊，只要咱是相信基督啊，咱就可能经历到真实真正的喜乐啊。
But it does not change the fact that this is a world at war.
但是这个事实上，咱所徛起的这个世界啊，依然是伫真正的当中啊。
Listen to 1 Peter 5:8. Be sober-minded. Be watchful.Your adversary, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, seeking someone to devour.
彼得前书第五章第八节清楚甲人讲啊，务必谨守警醒啊，因为恁会受敌魔鬼啊，亲像嚎叫的狮啊，偏对有形身体通吞食的人啊。
We are in spiritual warfare, whether you recognize it or not.
无论你要承认还是唔承认，咱今下日是处伫一个属灵的战争内。
The final victory has been won by Christ, but the battle still continues.
虽然咱已经知影，最后的胜利，基督已经赢胜利了，已经赢了咯。但是迄个战争确实也搁咧继续的，继续。
We are living in a time where our loving God is holding back His wrath until His work is completed.
人现在所徛起的这个时代呢，就是上帝啊，这个真有听心的上帝，有原地下咧吞忍忍耐着啊，无将伊的愤怒甲伊的心肝给 该到底这个社长啊，因为伊也跟挺好完成伊的工作。
And that work is the building of God's kingdom through the spreading of the gospel.
上帝工作是什么呢？上帝工作就是要接到啊，做这个传福音啊，啊，传片啊，福音传片啊，来建立伊的国度啊，伫这个世上。
God is at work redeeming the world through His church.
上帝工作是什么啊？伊是接到这个教会。
The enemy is going to hinder all of that through every means available to him.
These
are the end times. This is what Peter says in verse 4-7. The end of all things is at hand. Therefore, be self-controlled and sober-minded for the sake of your prayers.
Note
the therefore in this verse.
你注意到一日啊，一节里面一日所以。
We are given these commands in verse 7 to 11 about prayer, about love, about service, because the end is near. The end of all things being near changes how we live our lives.
What say 时代一定到了时啊，世界特别到末日的时阵，咱生活咱对咱的啊生命就有无相关的看法，咱就有一改变。
But when is the end going to come？
但是你问讲这个真正末日是几时会来到呢
？Did Peter think it was going to happen in their lifetime, or did he think it was？Thousands of years after he wrote these words.
When Paul wrote this,
Peter wrote this.
我相信彼得当时写的时阵，并不是咧自告讲末日要定得要到，随时要到，乃是讲说因开始活伫一个无相关的时代的里面。
Meaning something changed that signified that they were already in a different era or a different period of history.
啊，就是意思讲说有一挂代志一定改变了，所以表示讲说因现在所活的。是一定是另外一段的期间，过去的一段历史一定结束了。
One clue is in the use of the words "the last times" in 1 Peter 1:20, where he says, "He was foreknown before the foundation of the world, but was made manifest in the last times for the sake of you."
啊，咱若注意看的时阵啊，伊这个提示啊，就是记载的啊，彼得。前书第一章第二十节的一个所在啊，伊讲说基督的创世以前就是预先受上帝知影，却伫这个末世则为恁显现啊，是你末世啊，记载伫这个所在。
So he seems to equate the last times with the revealing of Jesus.
所以可能是咧将这个末世这个是你的这个时阵啊。
I also believe that no one really knows for sure when the end will come.
我是相信讲，无一个人完在啊清楚知影看末日多一日会来到。
In Acts 1:6-7, Jesus says to the apostles, including Peter. So when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel? He said to them, it is not for you to know times or seasons that the Father has fixed by his own authority. So Peter was not predicting that the end was coming very soon, but rather that they were in the last chapter of history.
So
my view is that he meant the end was near because the gospel has already been revealed. From that point on, salvation became available, and the gospel message started spreading throughout the whole world.
So, 对于暂时开始，救恩就开始，让人有法能得着，让人有法能得着救恩，并且呢。
This is the era of God building the eternal kingdom of Jesus Christ. It is a time when people can still experience the grace of God through the gospel of Jesus Christ. Now hopefully this crisis we're all facing will pass soon and the situation will improve. But it will not change the fact that it is still the end times even then. The main thing that is happening now is not COVID or any other world event, but it is the spread of the gospel throughout the whole world. What difference does it make if this is true? It means our lives have to reflect this. It means we don't have the time to spend our lives in the pursuit of trivial and meaningless things. How tragic would it be if we live this life passionately pursuing our own dreams, our own comfort, our own prosperity, while God has been inviting us to join Him in the building of His kingdom? Of course, we have to work. Of course, we have to provide for our families and to serve our community. But this means that all these things are part of the bigger picture of what God is doing in the whole world.
但是咱得记，无论咱做即跩个代志呢，咱所做工作应该是得伫上帝的这个大北的大位内面的一部分。
Jesus says in Mark 16:15-16, "Go into all the world and proclaim the gospel to the whole creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned."
耶稣基督在马可福音16:15-16，伊清清楚讲，你得恩公普天的去，传福音给万民。这个万民听，就是万民，就是指所有受造的。信而受洗，必然得救；无信的，必受定罪。
Now, this is not a suggestion. This is a command.
咱得真了解讲，这个不是一个对咱的建议，这个是对咱的一个命令。
So, are we obeying this command to proclaim the gospel?
咱有咧遵行耶稣基督的这个命令，出去传福音吗？是不？
In Matthew 28, Jesus calls it making disciples of all nations.
So in Matthew 28,
so we make disciples by proclaiming the gospel and teaching them how to obey the commands of Jesus. And to be clear, I'm not saying that you should only be sharing the gospel and doing nothing else. Of course not.
我清楚，其实我并不是意思讲，咱就是啊，专时间的咧啊，传福音，然后无去做其他的代志。
But it does mean that you arrange your life around that command to make disciples.
意思是讲说，咱就调整咱的生命，来活在这个耶稣基督的命令的边头，行来为伊帮助传福音的人做门徒。
So this is not an add-on to your lifestyle.
这个不应该是讲说，咱生活当中再个加添的物件。
When you decide about college courses, schools, professions, business, even life partners, one of the top questions you ask yourself is, how can I preach the gospel? How can I make disciples in these situations?
So, when we make any kind of decision, we ask ourselves, to study any kind of course, to go to which university, to do any kind of job, and then do any kind of business.或者选择上啊，做咱的终身的谈判，即跩问题，当咱咧问的时阵，咱同时就问一个问题：跩有法当怎啊来帮助我，和我当继续的五人团福音，然后帮助人解决问题。
That is why God is placing you exactly where you are。
就是因为安尼，上帝在将你徛伫现在你所点这个所在。
Maybe you will have a lot of disciples, or maybe you will only have one.
According, you will have a lot of disciples, but according, you will have a lot of disciples.
Maybe we only have time to disciple our children or our family members. But maybe some of us will have the space to disciple more people.
好，可能咱有较侪空间通来栽培较侪唔多。
It doesn't matter how much. What matters is that we do it.
是这个有偌侪，最少并不是第一重要。第一重要是讲咱有去做还是无。
At the time of this recording, there has been more than 36,000 deaths from COVID alone in the Philippines, not counting all the usual cause of death.
当咱咧录音的时阵，这段时间咱知影伫菲律宾影片已经有超过36,000人因为这个疫情的原因来死亡，这个也阁无包括其他死亡的原因。
how many of those would face judgment and the wrath of God because they are not in Christ?
你想歪，因为因在人有可能真侪无信主、无接受耶稣基督，因偌侪人就面对上帝的审判甲愤怒呢？
Now, this is not to paint a picture of helplessness or hopelessness, but rather to remind us what is at stake when we talk about making disciples of all nations.
我并不是伫遮爱来为一张真正绝望的道话，乃是要来提醒咱每一个人，互咱在讲说，要帮助，要来，互万民做门徒，应该要付出什么款的代价。So
I ask you, if you are not yet involved in this work of making disciples, why not?
所以我问你一个问题，讲当你若无参与伫何万民做耶稣基督的门徒的这样事工顶面，为什么你无参与？
What else is occupying you?
是什么代志咧，让你无闲？
And if you're listening to this message and you have not yet believed in the Lord Jesus as Lord and Savior, I urge you to do so.
啊，耶稣，你伫遮也是咧听这个信息，但是你却也阁未接受耶稣，做个恁的救主，会主甲救主的时阵，我劝你就赶紧安尼做。
We have been saying that we don't really know when the end will come.
咱实在唔知影讲说，啊，到底这个末日几时会来到？
You might feel like you still have the time to decide, but please do not delay.
刚才你想说，也够真长的时间，让你来啊，决做一个决定。但是求，请你唔能够延迟。
The gospel is spreading throughout the whole world, but Jesus is coming again.
这个福音继续伫咧，恩转世界，大家所在来传开，耶稣基督特别来。
And when that day comes, it will be too late.
当你个日子忽然间来到时阵。 咱的眼前，咱一定太过晚了。
So believe in the gospel of Jesus.
所以，咱就赶紧来相信耶稣的福音。
Now Peter then gives us four things to do because we are living in the end times.
因为咱现在已经活在这个末世时代，所以彼得就给咱四项代志，叫咱啊面临咱就去做。
These are things that we must do, as verse 11 says, in order that in everything God may be glorified through Jesus Christ.
这个，咱就跟着来听，听彼得来做这些代志，因为第十一节真清楚个人讲，叫上帝的万事显明，因为耶稣基督通得着荣耀。
We've been talking about such grand and cosmic ideas like the gospel spreading throughout the whole world.
咱继续在咧讨论到讲啊，这个啊福音传遍这个全世界，这项真正宏啊盛大啊全宇宙性的这代志啊。
And Peter is saying we can be part of that. Our lives can reflect that.
啊，彼得就咧个咱讲说啊，咱有法能伫这个工作里面是啊，真做啊，真做一部分啊，因为咱因咱的生命啊，有法能繁荣这项代志。But
here Peter gives us the specific things we can do to glorify God during this end times.
啊，彼得是这段时间，伊予咱一个啊四项啊一寡真正具体代志啊。
Now, surely this must be huge world-changing actions that he expects us to do, right?
可能你想讲说，啊，彼得的吩咐应该是一寡真正大项的代志，我能改变这个世界一寡行动。Maybe
you expect Peter to tell us to give up everything we have and to go to a place where Jesus is not proclaimed yet.
啊，刚才你想讲彼得那边，唔忙咱在做基督徒啊，就是啊，放下一切啊，然后去到一个也阁无受、无听到福音的所在啊，来工作啊。Well,
I believe God does call some people to do exactly that.
我相信上帝有呼召一挂的人啊，特别去做这款的工作。
But the four things Peter commands us to do in this passage, it is simple. It is not complicated.
但是当你观看这段经文的时阵，彼得所命令咱的罪啊，是真正简单，佮真正袂复杂的一件代志。
In fact, anyone can do it anywhere and anytime.
实际上，咱无论伫什么所在，无论伫什么时阵啊，大家人拢有法当来做这代志。
Peter tells us to pray, to love, to show hospitality, to serve each other with the gifts we have. Anyone can do this.
So Peter tells us to pray, to love, to show hospitality, to serve each other with the gifts we have.
Does not matter what your situation or talent is, you can do this.
不管你的温素是什么，你都有法当按你来做。
We actually don't have an excuse not to do this.
咱无有一个借口通来讲，咱无法当做这项代志。
Now, these aren't newsworthy or flashy actions, and no one might be impressed by these things.
咱所做出来要做的跩代志啊，唔是真正互人会纪念或者讲说人会注意的代志啊。
There's a message there already, right? Everyone has a part in glorifying God.
这个信息真正做，咱讲说，伫荣耀上对这样代志，人民啊，咱大家人应该着分。
God is glorified by these everyday normal things that we do that bless other people.
上帝，因为咱伫逐日的生活顶面真普通的代志啊，做出来啊，我当来托人得到祝福的时阵，伊的名就要得到荣耀。
Yes, you may not be as talented as other people, nor as good in speaking, but it does not matter.
可能咱无亲像别人遐有恩赐，也无亲像别人遐有讲话，但是这边不是特重要。
You can pray, love, and serve the same as any Christian.
你继续有法当为人祈祷，有法当听人，有法当服侍别人，亲像其他的基督徒朋友。
Since the end of all things is at hand, our prayer, love, and service to each other is what glorifies God.
就是因为现在末世时代特别来到，所以咱会彼此的代祷，咱会彼此相听，甲彼此的服侍呢，是发扬荣耀主的名。But
remember, these are commands to follow if and only if you are already a follower of Jesus.
但是咱得记得，这个命令，互咱来遵行的，是当跩一定完全相信啊，耶稣基督佮接受伊，才有法当安尼做。Because
you can't do this otherwise.
耶稣，你若佫袂接受耶稣基督，你就无法当安尼做。Now
we're commanded in verse 7 to therefore be self-controlled and sober-minded for the sake of your prayers.
第七节里叫咱讲说，要警醒、警修、警醒的基督。You
already know we should pray. You actually probably pray more during this pandemic.
你也是在讲说，咱要安尼来祈祷，并且现在这个疫情当中，我相信可能咱有较多时间来祈祷。But
this is saying that our prayers are directly affected by the reality that this is the end times.
但是第二啊，是可能怎样讲说，咱现在基督是甲这个现在这个时代是末世时代应该有啊真正直接的关系。You
don't pray only because there is something bad going on.
咱唔当因为有歹的代志在发生，咱才要起来祈祷。If
we have this end-time mentality, we can control our reactions to our situation and with clear eyes. We can pray for God's will in the situation to be done.
假使咱的思想一定真清楚，会看到关于这个末世时代的想法的时阵，咱就有法当来控制咱家己的反应，然后咱有真一个真正清清净的目睭，通看到啊，为上为啊为现在来祈祷，通让上帝的旨意完成伫这个世代。
That means on top of the urgent things we pray for. To be sober-minded means we know that we have to pray for God's agenda.
所以就是说我们除了普通时间所祈祷，咱就会记得咱的今生会为着上帝所安排的代志是以的议程来祈祷。
So we pray for the spread of the gospel, no matter what.
咱就为着福音广传这样代志，无论什么款的情形下面，来祈祷。
We are also commanded in verse 8 to, above all, keep loving one another earnestly, since love covers a multitude of sins.
咱的朋友，受命令来做，亲像第八节所讲的，要彼此切实的杀掉，因为听会加强真罪的罪。
Now, hopefully, we are already doing this in our church.
我知，我相信讲，咱伫这教会中间，咱一定有咧做这项的代志。
But to be clear, this does not mean that if we just love people, our sins will be forgiven.
咱一定听的是讲，唔是意思讲，咱彼此杀掉，听别人，咱的罪就会得到赦免。
It means to love each other to the point that you can look past all the offenses and annoyances that you have with your fellow brothers and sisters.
所讲意思就是讲说，咱就真心真正的杀掉，到一个程度呢，咱有法当无个计算，这些人咱教会咱的兄弟姊妹对咱的敌视，答和咱带来和咱的烦恼。
It's impossible that you love all the people in your church completely. You will get angry. You will get offended.
当然，真无可能讲说，咱有法当用专心来听所有的每一个兄弟姊妹，因为咱有时阵也阁是会生气，也阁是会失望。But
instead of holding on to it, Peter is saying to us, just love them.
但是，咱特别。 来看到这跩生气，甲是人的得失的时阵，伊得确实叫咱甲咱讲说，咱就继续的听别人，因为现在一定是末世的时代。Because
it's the end times.
因为现在是末世的时代。We
love other Christians so much that you can overlook their offenses.
咱就彼此杀掉，听别个信徒到一个程度，咱有法当忘记，甲无注意到伊对咱所的解释。And
those offenses don't mean much in the light of the end of all things.
就是因对咱的解释呢，会看起来一定无重要，因为甲这个末世时代所要发生的代志来对比的时阵，是太过微小。
We have better things to do, more disciples to make.
有咱有比较较重要、更加的代志要做，就是咱要帮到托拉更加侪人，正做上耶稣基督的门徒。The
next command is in verse 9, which says, "Show hospitality to one another without grumbling."
搁第刷落去一个命令，就是叫咱要互相款待，唔通发怨言。
We know it takes a lot of effort and hassle and cost to show hospitality.
咱在啊，当咱要伫遐来招待别人啊，热心款待人的时阵，通常咱就出真多人，后生真正麻烦，搁就出钱。So
during the time of Peter, it may have had more risk.
但是伫彼得当时嘅时阵啊，可能搁加一项啊，搁较大个，搁较有风险。To
host Christians in your own home would entail your family being identified as Christians and risking persecution.
当你邀请并且款待基督徒来到你的厝内时阵，无形中你一定是将你家己确和人确认做是一个基督徒，所以就得面对这跩风险。Peter
tells us to love each other, not just to the point where we overlook the offenses, but also to be willing to suffer.
所以彼得咧甲人讲，咱彼此杀掉到一个程度，唔是单单说袂记得因对咱的敌视，但乃是甚至着为因来受苦。
That means we love people sacrificially. Can this be done in a pandemic? Now, we're not saying that we ignore health protocol and just host each other in each other's homes without care, with abandon. That would be irresponsible. It would be sinful of us to do this. But it does mean being willing to do something necessary for a brother or sister, even if it is risky. I know of people who drove someone to the hospital because they had no other means of transportation. I know people who go out of their way to deliver things to those who are sick. And even online, there are ways to be hospitable. In a time where we are all sick and tired of online meetings, it is a sacrifice to connect with people. We have our limits, of course, but we do what we can. So we can check up on people, we can disciple them online. Now, I know a lot in the church is already doing this, but I encourage you to keep doing it more and more, because this is the things that glorify God. The next command is in verse 10 to 11. As each has received the gift, use it to serve one another as good stewards of God's varied grace. Whoever speaks as one who speaks oracles of God, whoever serves as one who serves by the strength that God supplies, in order that in everything God may be glorified through Jesus Christ. To Him belong glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Peter commands us to serve each other with our gifts. He gives two main gifts here, but it doesn't mean there are only two gifts. Now, there are people who are naturally gifted, right? In speaking, they're charming, quick-witted, entertaining. That is not what Peter is talking about. Now, if we are gifted and called to teach and preach the gospel, the word, he commands us to speak with all the reverence, seriousness, and passion that we can. But even if you are just sharing a devotion to your family or sharing a verse to a friend, you do it with the same passion. Because to speak the Bible means we are literally speaking God's words. Our words are dust in the wind, but God's word is living and powerful. If we serve people, if we do acts of love, Peter tells us to give it our all. But we are not to rely on our strength, which will eventually run out, but we serve people with the power of the Holy Spirit. It also means to do the service in submission to the Spirit, meaning you don't do things that are just for your own glory. It means to listen and obey whatever service God wants you to do, not just what you want to do. Whether we sing in front, or we stack chairs, or we design posters, or we cook meals for members, all of it is glorifying to God if it is done through the power of God. So we use the gifts that God gave us to serve each other. These four commands are not remarkable. If you do it, you may not get recognized. It is also true that some people can do these commands better than you. But that doesn't matter. What matters, dear Christian, is that you have the privilege to glorify God through the ordinary things that you do day by day. You may not be a big world changer right now. But these ordinary things we can do every day to pray, love, show hospitality, to serve each other.
但是咱伫特别生活当中，最真正普通有法当做诶代志，就是祈祷、沙听啊，彼此宽待、彼此服侍跩代志。
Think about this carefully. That impact is eternal.
这个影响是永恒诶。
Now listen to this line in a poem by C.T. Studd called "Only One Life."
啊，咱来注意听这个 C.T. Studd 所讲的一句话，就是“只有一条生命
”，Only one life will soon be passed. Only what's done for Christ will last.
咱只有一个生命，无偌久，一个生命就要过去。但是只有咱为着耶稣基督所做的物件，才会长存。
God bless you all.
愿主祝福咱每一位。
Now we have two discussion questions that you can use in your own groups.
咱只要有两个，咱就需要讨论的问题，咱通好好来思想。
First question: What needs to change in your life to reflect living in the end times?
咱的生命要有什么款的改变，才有法能反映给人看中，知影？咱现在一定活伫这个末世的时代。
Second, why would knowing this is the end times cause you to love, to pray, to serve other believers more?
为什么咱现在哪一点知影讲咱活着的是一个末世的时代的时阵，咱就需要讲搁较多的时间，搁较多的来祈祷。来彼此沙听，甲彼此服侍。
Let us receive the benediction. And after you have suffered a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to His eternal glory in Christ, will Himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and establish you. To Him be the dominion forever and ever. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, we pray this. Amen.